Dear students, good morning. In the series of spoken English, today is 12th day. And our topic is prepositions. Topic is prepositions. Dear students, already I told you that English is a very easy language. Something is difficult for us when we only do not know it. So knowing it is very important. As soon as you know it, it will be very easy for you. So try to understand what are prepositions. See, here already we studied that there are 8 parts of speech. Nouns we have studied, pronouns we have studied, adjective we have studied, verbs we have studied, adverbs we have studied. Now number 6 is prepositions. So what are prepositions? First I am giving example, then you understand what are prepositions. Examples. See, see the picture. There is one table and on the table there is one ball. So sentence is, a ball is on the table. A ball is on the table. A ball is on the table. Understand? Focus on the table. Second one, try to understand. You see, this ball is under the table. A ball is under the table. Under the table. And third example, this is also table, but ball is here. The ball is beside the table. The ball is beside the table. Try to understand in different cases, different prepositions are there. Beside. See, here in one picture, first picture, ball is on the table. In second picture, ball is under the table. And third picture, the ball is beside the table. Here, on, under, and beside. Beside, on, under, and beside are the prepositions. Are the prepositions. See, after seeing example, we can define prepositions. So what are prepositions? How can we define prepositions? So prepositions are the words which show position of one thing, position of one thing, one thing or a person in relation to the other thing or a person. Preposition shows position of one thing in relation to the other. After understanding what are prepositions, we should see types of prepositions. Types of prepositions or kinds of prepositions. Kinds of prepositions. Already I told you that nothing is difficult, only trying to understand carefully is very necessary to make something easy. Kinds of prepositions, there are two types of prepositions based on their composition and function. There are two types of prepositions based on their number one compositions and functions, number two functions. Now first we'll see number one preposition based on their compositions. Number one prepositions based on composition. Based on their composition. Composition. Number one, simple prepositions. Based on their composition, there are four types of prepositions based on composition. Based on first we have seen there are two types of prepositions based on composition and based on function. And now based on composition there are four types of prepositions. Four types of prepositions. Number one, simple prepositions. Number two, compound prepositions. Number three, double prepositions. And number four, phrase prepositions. These are four types of prepositions based on their composition. Now let us see one by one. Number one, let us see one by one. Simple prepositions. Number one, simple prepositions. Simple prepositions. Simple prepositions are words like simple prepositions are words like in, on, at, about, over, under, off, for, to, etc. Now let us see example how we use it. Simple provisions. Examples. I sat on a sofa. On is preposition showing position of person in relation to sofa. Second example. He fell off the ladder. He fell off the ladder. He fell off the ladder. Second one, number two, compound prepositions. Compound prepositions are words. Compound prepositions are words like without, within, inside, outside, into, behind, between, etc. These are examples of compound prepositions. Let us see examples. Example. He fell into the river. He fell into the river. He fell into the river. Second, there is nothing inside the jar. There is nothing inside the jar. Inside, here into, inside are compound prepositions. Compound means which is made joining two prepositions. With, out, without, with, in, within, inside, inside, outside, outside, in, into, behind, between, etc. Next one, number three, third number, number three. Double prepositions are words outside of. Here double means having two prepositions together. Outside of, out of, from behind, and from beneath, etc. From beneath. electrical. Now let us see example of double loop equations. Example, he walked out of the room, he walked out of the room. Two equations are there, so it is called double equations, out of the room. Second one, he emerged from behind the curtain, from behind the curtain. Emerging, coming out from behind the curtain. Emerging means suddenly appearing. Emerging means suddenly appearing from behind the curtain. Now let us see next type of precautions. Free precautions number 4. Like because of this is phrase, two words together, because of, by means of, with regard to. On behalf of, on account of, opposition to, for the sake of. Here free preposition means prepositions are in a phrase. Now let us see examples. Example, he succeeded by means of hard work. By means of, this is free preposition. He succeeded by means of hard work. Second, the match was cancelled. Was cancelled because of rain. Because of here free preposition. Now we have seen first type of prepositions, preposition based on composition. We have seen four types of prepositions: simple prepositions, then we have seen compound prepositions, double prepositions, and free prepositions. Now second type of prepositions based on their function. Let us see. Prepositions based on their function. Second type of prepositions, number two. Prepositions based on their functions. Based on their functions, there are three types of prepositions. There are three types of prepositions based on their function, based on their function. Based on their functions. Number one, prepositions of time. Prepositions of time. Second, prepositions of place. Of place. And third one is prepositions of directions. Prepositions of directions. Now we have to study these three types of preposition based on their function. Number one, prepositions of time. There are three prepositions of time. There are three prepositions of time. Prepositions of time. At, in, on. There are three prepositions of time. Let us see uses of at. Number one, uses of at. We use add with time, meal, and occasion or events. Example, we have breakfast at 7 o'clock. At 7 o'clock. Here at shows time, so this is preposition of time. Second, at breakfast they talk a lot. This is at breakfast, means here we add with the time, meal. This is meal and occasions. So this is first time, shows time. Second, meal, to show meal time. And third one is she met me at a concert. Concert. Here concert means performance of music. Performance of music. She met me at a concert. Here at 7 o'clock time, at breakfast, meal time, and at a concert, that is event or occasion. Second is in. Let us in. Number second, in. Use of in. In. We use in with. We use in with. With season. Season, month, month, year, year, century, part of the day and part of the day. Of the day. For example, it rains a lot in any season. It rains a lot in rainy season. Rainy season. In rainy season means in the period of rainy season. In rainy season. Number second. Her school will reopen. Reopen in June. Here in again shows time. Third example, Gandhiji died in 1948. Here in shows again time. Next example, let's move out in the evening. Let's move out in the evening. This again shows time. In this way, we have seen the uses of time, prepositions for time, on a Sunday day. Here on shows time. Again, second example, Gandhiji was born on October 2. So Here one note is there. Okay, you should remember a note. Remember we do not use in, on, and at before these words next last every today tomorrow still each some any and one. Number two, prepositions of place. Prepositions of place. This preposition of place will continue tomorrow. This is my subset for today. Thank you very much.